Alright. Hello, everyone. BlackCross here. How's everyone doing tonight so far? Well, so, in the last video, live stream rather, we started in the cave in order to make our way into the Esper's world. So, we're going to continue onward. Might as well be ready to pull my map out so I don't forget where I'm at. Alright then. So here we go. Go ahead and make our way. Probably should have done some grinding as the week went by, but didn't think to. Also, too, someone was telling me the, my allergies. But, someone's been telling me about, you know, the proper pronunciations on some of these characters. Kane, if I'm correct on this assumption, technically it is pronounced, I guess it's pronounced like, give me just a sec. It's technically pronounced like Psy or something. But in all honesty, I think for the sake of it, I'm just gonna keep calling him Kane. Just because the name itself it looks like Kane. To me it does. As for Gaiu, apparently it's pronounced Gao. Like cow. Like, oh well, that's disconcerting. But I can call him Gao, that's no problem. Cause I mean, at least that part sounds better. Gao does. Dag gum gal. Again, the quadruple hit. Hope you'll do that whenever we get to the boss. It's like, holy shit, that's a lot. And I might as well get this treasure box while I'm at it. Okay, good. I shall take ether. I'm using a lot of magic now, so therefore, having ether would definitely benefit me. Also, to let people know, I am not sick. It's just my allergies won't leave. I think I'm just gonna default to keep using that, cause that seems to be helping me. A lot, actually. Holy crap. That's insane.
Zoom in on this one.
Okay. Okay, I think we need to go this way. I think. Holy shit. Even when we're back attacked, that thing is powerful. Guy was just killing everything. I am so glad Guy was doing really good. Oh boy. Well, now he's a zombie. Do I have anything to cure a zombie? Let's see. I do have something. There we go. How's everyone doing on skills so far? Okay, he's got Carbuncle. He's almost got Haste Learn, which will definitely help. Once we get Haste, it's going to be dramatically different. Okay, we still got Float, so we'll keep him on there. You're getting there, but not quite. Oh, you've already maxed everything. Having you with 10% more HP would be nice, so we'll go ahead and keep that on you. And then once you maxed out and leveled up a bit, I'm gonna switch you out with someone else. Probably with... Ancestor's got the most HP out of everyone. Then again, he is at level 22, so... Probably attach you to Gao, probably. That might make better use. Okay, what have we got? Got two magics out of that. Summon random Esper. Alright then. You don't say. Magic power goes down by 2, but that attack power is very nice. And power grows as HP grows. If it's like that throughout the entire game, that's gonna be very nice to have. Okay, that takes care of one. Okay, so now I gotta look and see... Because apparently Remedy does not cure Zombie. As I have just read. Yeah. Cures status elements except Zombie. So it would not work. Okay. Everything is set for what I want. Something tells me that zombie is going to stay with me for a while. Wish I had prepared better. I'm just wondering, if he stays undead, does that mean that he doesn't die, or are we ultimately screwed? Okay, he's attacking them, so... Oh, now I've got two zombies! And they can't die! Okay. We are at a dilemma right now. Zombie is not curable by remedy. And I can't cure them to kill them. Nor can I use life. I'm just wondering if I should go ahead and try to exit out of here and try to get things recovered. Cause I mean, that gum and all. But I just ain't screwed. Okay, so, translation. Zombie equals death. Permadeath, apparently. Until I cast zombie on them. That's actually kind of annoying, what that is. It's like, okay, first and foremost, zombie usually can be got rid of. It's a long process, admittedly, but it's a process that can be done. But it's one of those processes that's like, it's kind of nerve-wracking. But usually, the only way to fix zombie, with the exception of, like, maybe, you know, using an element that cures zombie, is to cure them, in which case it kills them. So then you can use life and bring them back. It's annoying is what it is. Because by using zombie, it means that you can't heal them, because they're gonna die. But in this game, apparently zombie equals to permadeath, unless healed, with the item that cures zombie, or an ability called zombie. To which, as far as I know, I do not have the ability to do that. Speaking of which... Okay, you've still got a little bit before Remedy's done. Just wanted to make certain. Wait, hold on a second. Hold the phone. It didn't reset. They kept their levels when they die? Did anyone catch that? I know whenever I checked the menu before I died, some of them was at level 21. Now, they're at level 22. So it doesn't backtrack. It carries over after they're... How did that work? I mean, death is death. Never mind. Either way, I don't have to worry about losing that much levels. But then their skill ability reset. But not their levels. Can anyone make sense of that part? It's like, okay, their level didn't reset, but their skill level did. Like, their ability skills did reset. So, what's the difference? That's kind of a weird thing right there. He hurt himself and healed himself. I definitely want to go in there to get those items, because that sword one will definitely help. Oh, for the love of criminy Christmas. You know, I'm going to see if this does anything. Because they are zombies. Okay, it does work. So it makes me wonder if life works. Okay, it does work. Note it. It took me this long to think about it, and it's like, wait a second, I'm doing this the hard way. They're technically quote-unquote zombies, which means I can just use life to kill them. But with every game series, there's always going to be a different rule set. Sometimes it doesn't work that way. Sometimes it's just, I'm undead, but you trying to revive me only hurts me even more. At least this way I can prevent zombie now. That's a nice little thing to have. Although that makes me wonder, are those things considered undead? If it wasn't for the fact they're already dead now, I test that theory. Let's take a look-see. How much more... Oh wait, he's blind? Okay, so one more fight, and she should be ready to use Remedy. Which would be nice. Okay. So, considering the fact... Let's see... Probably a good idea to switch her Esper with another. Let's see, Zessers... Not quite. Not exactly. Something tells me, not even close. Getting there, but not quite. Okay. So then I guess... Because having two characters with life would probably be beneficial. Okay, we'll test the theory out. Aha! This narrows it down. It's using a lot of MP, but you know what? Don't care. Like, now I know. Okay, we're gonna switch Terra's Esper real quickly into that one Esper that gives 10% HP. Cause that's gonna help. Okay. Let's see, was this? Yeah, it was. Okay. Carbuncle, Shrey... Let's take a look at this. Not even close. What about you? Slowly. We are slowly getting there. We'll heal our MP in just a sec. That will help tremendously now. There's a switch inside. What will you do? Doesn't really say what it does. So, flick the switch. It didn't do anything. Probably just a random button. Okay. Get rid of you. Everyone's gaining a level so far. It'd probably be wise to go ahead and recuperate now. That way, Tara's got all of her MP. Don't really need that anyway. Her MP is probably almost out, so we better take a look. See how it's almost gone. We'll give her 2. That'll keep us going until we get to the save point. Oh, come on. Really, another one? Could you please stop that? That's very annoying right now. What was that? I'm confused. What just happened to Terra? If there was a way that she could keep doing that, that would be greatly appreciated. But I sincerely doubt that. Okay. Now the Sessors learn haste. I really feel more comfortable if there was more of this, so we're gonna switch him out. We know Carbuncle still has a little bit before it's mastered, but I would prefer to go ahead and just get that out of the way. Okay. Set up a 10, get everyone fixed up. Save, and then we will bolt our way towards the end, because I think, if what I'm looking here is correct, we need to get to the other side where those, according to what it says, moving islands. The quote-unquote moving islands. Okay, Gal just had master that one summon, so that's good. Now he can cast magic, which is very beneficial. Let's see. If we're gonna put him with healing. We're gonna stick with him with something that has bonus points for MP. So we'll hand do that. Cause I think he's like, okay, so he's not the lowest, but he was just about to be the lowest. So this will help us. We'll eventually get to the other side. Oh, for the love. Okay, Sethra's learned Cure. Now I have two healers. That will help. I think that's where I need to be at. Yeah, it is. Okay. So then why would I want to move that island? Okay, we're almost out of here. Thank goodness. Okay. And just in time, too. Here we are, finally. Gosh. There's the door. The door to the Esper's world. This is the sealed gate. What an eerie place. Why'd you bring me to such an awful place? Kefka? Oh shit, of course. Terra! The gate! Quickly! Kefka! You followed us! The Emperor was right! Let Terra fall into your hands! And you open the gate for us! Now, how does it feel to know you've been working for us? Now I fear you've outlived your usefulness. You better think again, Kefka. Oh dear. You want to fight me? This is just dreadful. Keep Kefka busy until Terra slips through the gate. Okay, how do I know when she's finally slipped through? And goodness, I've got Sessor learning healing weapon, healing magic. It helps. Look, the door is opening. That was quick. Espers, please heed my call. It's opened! Terra! I feel so anxious. Something's coming. Oh, what have we unleashed? Frightful energy. Terra! Hey, the gate! Well, I don't think no one's gonna get in there anytime soon. Judging by the way it looks. What about those Espers? Look, let's return to the airship. Alright then. Oh, we actually have to walk back. Of course, it couldn't be easy for us to escape this place. Boy, we leveled up quite a bit in here. Where'd this lead? Oh, to the exit. Oh, thank goodness. What happened? The Espers flew off together. Then the Emperor's citizens ran off as though... I need to figure out how to speak, apparently. Then the Emperor's citizen ran off as though they were terrified. Which way did the Espers go? Towards the capital. Vector. So we're heading back to Vector, huh? We're almost at Vector. There! What's that? Uh-oh. What's wrong, Terra?
I can feel it. It's coming closer and closer.
What do you mean you can feel it?
It was glowing.
What's that?
It can't be.
An Esper? It's coming! Watch out, Terra! That would be Bahamut. What was that? Cesar, get down! Never mind. Every Esper is coming after us. Including Carbuncle, apparently. Real Espers? Where are they going?
They were mad. They seemed angry. No. Stop. Please. Don't go!
Forget that. What's with this vibration? Is it from the Espers? Cesar? I've lost control! Well, that's not good. Oh dear Lord Almighty. We land somewhere soft. Okay, here we go. I was worried for a second. Somehow we need to tap into the power of those Espers. Let's see, have I got everybody? Yeah, I've got everybody with me. Probably a good idea to switch out party members. Actually, let me go ahead and take a look at their equipment while I'm at it, too. Okay, I think this is a good time to go ahead and go for the time clicker here. So for those of you on YouTube, I shall catch you in the next video, but for those of you watching on Twitch, give me just a sec.